his own savior. I know I can make it on my own if I try, but I'm searching for a great heart to stand me by underneath the African sky. A great heart to stand me by.
For those of you who don't know, I'm Marion, I'm David's mother. I'd like to welcome you all here this evening on behalf of David and Julia and our families. I'd like to thank you all for being here. We realise the efforts and the plans on your part in order to get here. You've come from various parts of the world, and this is greatly appreciated. All of you have contributed in some way to David and Julia's lives, to David and Julia as a couple, or to them as individuals. Some of you will possibly not know David very well, and some of you will not know Julia very well. Many of you do not know each other, and this is the first time that we are meeting, and yet we all have something in common, and that is David and Julia. The reason for us being here this weekend. On behalf of both families, I'd like to welcome you to this celebration this weekend as David and Julia commit to each other in marriage. And thank you for all that you mean to David and Julia and for the different aspects that you bring to them, to their lives. It's a bit awkward.
Yeah, I can hold the torch.
Yes, you can hold the torch.
Yes, hold the
torch. Yeah, right, thank you. That's better. In closing, I'd just like to bring a blessing from an old neighbour of ours, Auntie Iris. David will remember her. She's an 86-year-old lady now, and she sent this text through. David hasn't seen her for many years, but she remembers David. David used to go and visit her when he was about 2.5 years old. He used to walk across to her garden. And she said to me, "Tell David, a little boy once sat on my garden wall and said, 'You've got millions of flowers. We are going to have a garden like this too.' I wish David and Julia every happiness and a garden with millions of flowers. God bless you both.
Hi, everyone. For those that don't know me, I'm Andrew. And I actually get kind of nervous in speeches. But I've been a housemate of Jules and Dave for the past 3 years. I've known there will be a lot said about Jules and Dave tomorrow. But I would just like to take this opportunity to thank Lorna and Marion for organising this amazing braai. Is that right? Yeah. It's a good start. All right. Jules and Dave are both incredible people. Living with them over the past 3 years, I've known them to be caring, generous, and fun without any exaggeration. They have felt more like family than housemates. Jules and Dave are quite different people, but they complement each other very well. They're the perfect match. So I think the memo that I was given for Jules and Dave was for the purpose of starting the festivities. And throughout med school, our house has always been the party house. So if everyone could raise their glasses and cheers to Jules and Dave. Thanks, guys.
Who made me here and why? beneath the copper sun. My very first beginning beneath the copper sky. Of all divine, and we are specimens of Africa, both you and I.
Oh, mama, yeah.
We're on the road to Pelamanga beneath this copper sky, and we are specimens of Africa on a journey to the stars.
Oh, mama, yeah.
Far below, we live forever, dreams of what we want.
Love can cross borders and love can break walls. Love can us, love can define us. Love can see through what eyes can undo.
Love got me thinking, love can do anything.
Love can cross borders and love can break walls.
Love can unbind us, love can define us.
Love can see through what eyes can undo.
Love got me thinking, love.
Driving to our ceremony at the moment along this dirt road, and I know a lot of people have asked me whether I was nervous about this wedding, and I know we've spoken about it before, and I'm really not nervous. It's just that trying to make sure you fit everything in and get in on time, always a bit of a struggle. And anyway, really looking forward to it, and I'll chat to you very soon. Lots of love.
In store, for the heart that is bursting, the soul that is thirsting. We are free.
Hey. Mrs. Robinson, Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Susie Rees-Jones. I'm a registered civil celebrant, duly authorised to conduct marriage ceremonies in accordance with law. It's my very great honour and privilege to marry Julia and David today. Julia called me last April and told me her exciting news. She and David were planning on getting married at the end of this year. Because I'm a lawyer, she thought I could marry them. But actually you can't as a lawyer. You must go and do a proper course to become a celebrant. So that I have duly done. And I said to Julia, I would be totally honoured to marry them both on one condition. She didn't mind if I cried. And forgive me if I end up looking like a raccoon today. I've lost it 3 times so far today. So please bear with me and please forgive me. Julia, or my hat, as our nickname is in our family, holds a very special place for us. We've known the Inman family since they came to Melbourne. See, here I've died already, sorry. When she was a nanny to our dear friend, to my daughter Zoe. Sometime later, Julia asked me to write a reference for med school for her. I wrote to Notre Dame that you can bestow no greater honour on somebody to care for your child, and that was how we held the regard we held for Julia in our family. Like a number of other special people here today, Julia is like another daughter for us. So, my fellow mothers of the bride, and so far I have counted four, Madame, Osi, we all come from a different continent. Of course, we pay homage to the gorgeous Lorna. Always. So it's my honour to represent you all here today. Now, interestingly, David, there are a number of people who've introduced themselves to me as your mother here, your other mother. And so far I've counted two, but I'm sure I haven't got round all the room. And I'm sure they're including Dean's mum for one, the chair, another one. And again, they live on different continents. So I'm also here for you today too. It's very clear to me David is a very gentle and thoughtful man. At the ripe old age of 3, in an incident with a pretty nasty traffic warden, Marion was reduced to tears. David asked his mother, "Did that man make you cry, Mummy? I'm going to ride over him with my tricycle." And I think that sums up David. For us Australians, David first came into our lives in 2010 when I got a call from Lorna saying Julia had met a chap from Cape Town. Sounds very nice. We knew things were getting really serious when Julia called me and said, we're going up to Queensland and I'm taking David to meet Mum and Dad for the first time. Could we come and stay the night at the beach house on the way first? I said, love to come. David's engaging eyes and his gentle aura struck me from the outset. He was such a gentleman, came into the house, about 15 minutes later, he poured me a champagne, but it was the dishwasher that got me. He emptied the dishwasher. I called Lorna about half an hour later. I said, I don't care what you do. I don't care how you do it. You just tell me what we got to do to help you keep him in the family. He's gorgeous. You're going to love him. So I hope you appreciate all why I feel so personally privileged to conduct this ceremony. And it's an amazing experience to share such an intimate program or thoughts with such a lovely couple. And so it's my absolute pleasure to officiate for you both today. So ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, we're going to start the ceremony and I'm going to ask dear friend of the bride, Jade Evans, to come and read The Art of Marriage. Jade.
The Art of Marriage by Wilfred A. Peterson. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It's never going to sleep angry. It's at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together, facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humour. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. It is discovering what marriage can be at its best.
Ladies and gentlemen, when I asked Julia why she wanted to marry David, she said, and I quote, "We are best friends, and I cannot ever imagine even a day of my life without him." Julia went on to say, "David is the best thing that has ever happened to me. I love him and I admire him so much." Now, when I asked David the same question, he sat there and he thought, there's only one word. He said, "Everything." Julia is amazing. She's adventurous and she keeps me on my toes. She has such spirit. She is generous and kind, and it's such a pleasure to be with her. David and Julia's marriage vows are very inspiring, and they are to remind us all that true love can flourish despite the tyranny of distance, two continents and 10,314 kilometres. More than a ceremony or a big celebration, this is also a significant moment of personal commitment. The essence of this commitment is taking one another in their entirety as a companion and lifelong friend. Julia and David, it is a requirement of the Marriage Act that before you are joined in marriage in my presence and in the presence of these witnesses, your family and your dear friends, I must remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship that you are about to enter. As Julia and David now wish to be united, to share their life together, if anyone can show just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, please speak now. Now, who brings Julia to be married to David?
I do.
Together and you know what you know, and you are the ones who'll decide where to go. You'll look up and down streets, look them over with care. About some you'll say, we don't choose to go there. With your head full of brains and your shoes full of feet, you're too smart to go down any not so good street. And you may not find any you'll want to go down. In that case, of course, you'll head straight out of town. It's opener there, in the wide open air. Out there things can happen, and frequently do, to people as brainy and footsy as you two. And when things start to happen, don't worry, don't stew, you'll go right along, and you'll start happening too. Oh, the places you'll go. You'll be on your way up, you'll be seeing great sights. You'll join the high flyers who soar to high heights. You won't lag behind because you'll have the speed. You'll pass the whole gang and you'll soon take the lead. Wherever you fly, you'll be best of the best. Wherever you go, you'll top all the rest. Except when you don't, because sometimes you won't. I'm sorry to say so, but sadly it's true that bang-ups and hang-ups can happen to you. You can get all hung up in a prickly perch, and your gang will fly on, you'll be left in a lurch. You'll come down from the lurch with an unpleasant bump, and the chances are then you'll be in a slump. And when you're in a slump, you're not in for much fun. Unslumping yourselves is not easily done. You'll come to a place where the streets are not marked. Some windows are lighted, but mostly they're dark. A place that could sprain both elbow and chin. Do you dare to stay out? Do you dare to go in? How much can you lose? How much can you win? And if you should go in, should you turn left or right? Or right and three quarters? Or maybe not quite? Or go around and back and sneak from behind. Simple, it's not, I'm afraid you'll find, for a mind maker upper to make up their mind. You can get so confused that you'll start to race down long and wiggled roads at a breakneck pace, and grind on for miles across weirdish wild space, headed, I fear, towards a most useless place. No, that's not for you. Somehow you'll escape all that waiting. You'll find the bright places where the boom bands are playing. famous can be, with the whole wide world watching you win on TV. Except when they don't, because sometimes they won't. But on you will go, though the weather be foul. On you will go, though your enemies prowl. On you will go, though the hack and cracks howl. Onward up many a frightening creek, though your arms may get sore and your sneakers may leak. On and on you will hike, and I know you'll hike far, and face up to your problems, whatever they are. You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many stray birds as you go. So be sure when you step. Step with care and great tact. And remember that life is a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous and deft, and never mix up your right foot with your left. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. Kids, you'll move mountains. So be your name Julia or David or Inman or Roberts, Dennis, Madeleine. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So get on your way.
Ladies and gentlemen, Julia and David will now make their promises to each other to create the bonds of marriage in order to become husband and wife. These promises are not to be entered into lightly. They should be in the belief that your marriage will be lifelong and be based on principles of partnership, love, trust, respect, forgiveness, and understanding. For and in all aspects of your life together. David Dennis, do you take Julia Madeleine to be your lawfully wedded wife? Do you love her, comfort her, honour and respect her? Do you promise to share all life has to offer, your hopes and your dreams, your achievements and your disappointments with her from this day forward?
I do.
Julia Madeleine, do you take David Dennis to be your lawfully wedded husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and respect him? Do you promise to share all life has to offer, your hopes, your dreams, your achievements and your disappointments with him from this day forward?
I do.
David, please repeat after me. I call upon the persons here present.
I call upon the persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
David Dennis Roberts.
David Dennis Roberts.
Take you.
Take you.
Julia Madeleine Inman.
Julia Madeleine Inman.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife. Julia. You're an amazing person, companion and friend. You are courageous and energetic. I have learned so much from you in the way in which you approach life and love. I respect you, I adore you, I am delighted that we will be tackling life together as a team. I promise to have every day open and honest communication with you about my thoughts, my feelings, aspirations, and openly communicate any grievances in a non-accusational, constructive way. We're getting it. I promise to maintain a philosophy of kindness towards you and our relationship from today and forever. I promise to maintain various interests, to keep myself both interesting and to you, and to make every effort to be interested in the things that make you happy. I promise that while maintaining individuality, I will make significant decisions with you and never alone. I promise to be devoted to you in this relationship and for the rest of our lives.
Julia, please repeat after me. I call upon the persons here present.
I call upon the persons here present.
To witness.
To witness.
That I.
Julia Madeleine Inman.
Julia Madeleine Inman. Take you.
Take you.
David Dennis Roberts.
David Dennis Roberts.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
Your integrity, your generosity, your humour, and your strong work ethic are all key to who you are, and I admire these qualities of you so very much. I love you for all the small reasons and the big ones too. You inspire me and improve me in so many ways. You've taught me to be more patient and considered in my thoughts and actions. You've taught me how to better focus on what's important and enjoy life. Enjoy the moment. I always enjoy life. Enjoy the moment. Someone once told me that the most important characteristic for any lasting relationship is respect. True respect. Because respect for somebody is the accumulation of so many other fundamental attributes. David, I really do respect who you are and what you stand for, and I aspire to be more like you in so many ways. We share the small moments in life as well as the big ones. We've laughed, fought a little, and confided greatly. You're my best friend, and I'm your biggest admirer and supporter. Being a life partner has been the best thing that's ever happened to me, and I'm so excited to spend the rest of our years ahead as a loving and committed team. From today, you're not only my best friend, but you're also my family too. So I promise, as you did, to have everyday open and honest communication with you about my thoughts, feelings and aspirations, and to openly communicate any grievances in a non-accusatory way. I promise to maintain a philosophy of kindness towards you and our relationship from today and forever. I promise to maintain various interests, to keep myself both interesting to you and to make every effort to be interested in the things that make you happy. I promise that while maintaining individuality, I will make significant decisions with you and never alone. I promise to be devoted to you and this relationship for the rest of our lives.
I now ask that each of you place these rings not only as a sign to all that you are husband and wife, but in recognition of the vows that you have just exchanged today. So David, as you place the ring on Julia's finger, please repeat after me. With this ring I marry you.
With this ring I marry you.
It is a recognition.
It is a recognition.
Of my promises.
Of my promises.
And it signifies my love.
And it signifies my love.
And commitment to you.
And commitment to you.
Very good. Well done. Okay, Julia. Thank you. Repeat after me. With this ring I marry you.
With this ring I marry you.
It is a recognition of my promises.
It is a recognition of my promises.
And it signifies my love and commitment to you.
And it signifies my love and commitment to you.
So Julia and David, you put it on the finger now. You will begin your journey bound by the vows that you have just promised each other. You'll take many paths and you're going to share many dreams. Today's wedding promises are about love, hope and respect. Marriage is always challenging, but in the immortal words of the extraordinary French novelist George Sand, there is only one happiness in life, and that's to love and to be loved. So ladies and gentlemen, Julia and David have declared before me and before all of you, their family and their dearest friends, that they'll live together in marriage, and they have symbolized it by joining hands, taking vows, and exchanging rings. So it is my very, very great pleasure to declare David and Julia to be husband and wife. Woohoo! So I'm going to invite David and Julia and their witnesses. Now, interestingly, David and Julia have chosen their mothers to be their witnesses, which is gorgeous. So Lorna and Marion.
Kills me. thing that drowns
Fantastic.
Me makes me want to
fly.
I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, so no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars.
Take
that money, watch it burn, sing in the river, the lessons I learned.
Take that money, watch it burn, sing in the river, the lessons I learned.
Take that money, watch it burn, sing in the river, the lessons I learned. Everything that kills me makes me feel alive.
Yeah, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could.
Sepia tone, love me. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart. Why are we here and where do we go? We're knocking us so hard. It's not always easy and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars and we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
Hello.
moments just might find their way into my dreams tonight. But I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. To me, the things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. When I sleep in heaven, and when I wake up, you look so pretty sleeping next to me.
I want to thank you all for coming here and helping us celebrate the wedding of Julia and David. And I also especially want to thank many people who've come from overseas. I mean, from all over the world. We've got people from the United States who are living there. We've got people from New Zealand, from Australia, of course, from South Africa, and also from Europe. So we've got a pretty good sort of mix of people here. And thank you all for coming here to help us celebrate this occasion. Unfortunately, we're not able to welcome Julia's godfather, Chick, and his wife, Jo. Chick passed away, unfortunately, a month ago, but just prior to this, he did expressly ask me to wish you two all his best wishes and good luck for your marriage. They were so looking forward to being here, but unfortunately, he said, no, my illness is overtaking me. It is customary for fathers to talk about their daughter and their bride and how the bride and bridegroom met and the events that have led up to today. Now, some of you who've, in fact, many of you have been to the engagement parties, one which was held here in Cape Town and one which was held here in, in Australia. But I didn't attend the second one. Okay.
So there were three engagement parties,
two of which I spoke at. Now apparently I spoke at great length, and we went into minutiae of their relationships and how they grew up and all the rest of it. So I won't go into quite that sort of length, but some of you do not know the full story. So I will give you a very brief resume. All of you may, or some of you may, or most of you probably realize that Julia met David in Cape Town. And this was while she was doing volunteer work at various hospitals prior to the commencement of her medical studies in Australia. And this is where I have to refer to my Land Rover, my list. What happened was this relationship sort of developed, and we were quite surprised, in fact, how it developed, because we just thought it was one of these holiday type romances. Julia returned to Australia, and we were amongst many others, were quite surprised at how this relationship progressed, and more than progressed, developed into what it eventually became. The journey backwards and forwards between South Africa and Australia was just extraordinary. But here we are today celebrating their marriage. We've seen Julia grow into the lovely, mature young woman that she is today. But this is in no small part due to the influence of David. There is a lot of elements of yin and yang in their relationship. And we all know Julia to be quite sort of forceful and, has strong opinions about things, etc., and is of high energy. And but like all of us, she can suffer from periods of anxiousness and self-doubt. Whilst David, on the other hand, has a sort of more calm sort of approach to life. He's very laid back. And this became particularly useful during the very stressful sort of periods that took place during Julia's sort of medical studies, and he calmed her down and encouraged her. So it was just one of those great things. So Julia began her life with a very difficult birth. And with considerable effort from her mother. And also the hospital staff. She was safely delivered with much relief and pride. And I always remember looking at the determined look on Julia's little face when she first made her appearance in the world. And it was accompanied by a loud yell at the top of her voice, a harbinger of things to come. I have to be quite frank, Julia was not an easy child. But we knew fairly early on, that's Laura and myself, that Julia was going to make her way successfully in the world. Her strong personality, demonstrating her opinion of trying to do things always her own point of view, but she also had a high sense of adventure, but these sometimes overshadowed other qualities that she had, which was of compassion and a sense of fair play. And as she got older, these qualities became more and more evident. Laura and I are still awed by her sense of adventure and courage when she traveled on her own from Helsinki to Beijing, overland. And no flying or anything like that. And the distance that she traveled, funnily enough, from west to east, was further than the distance that Marco Polo traveled. And she was inspired by this. We all met, I don't know whether you saw the program some years ago, The Long Way Around, which with Ewan McGregor and Charlie Borman, when they sort of went on these motorbikes across the world. And Julia saw this and she was totally inspired by this story and said, I want to do that. That's what she did. She went by train, bus, car, on foot. She climbed the fantastic mountains of the Altai Mountains on the borders of Mongolia, Kazakhstan, and Russia. She went right up to the snow line there without any proper equipment. And what little equipment she had somehow or other disappeared into Lake Baikal, some of it was recovered, I understand. Not a phone, though. She slept in yurts, and she even went for a jog along the Great Wall of China. A lot of things to remember, maybe to tell your children about one day. Julia's journey through life. Well, Julia's journey one day. Got a little bit sort of distracted there. Julia's journey through life could also be titled The Long Way Around. And to where she is today. She, at the end of finishing her year 12, which is the final years of school, she decided she was going for a gap year to go to France. And she then went to France for a year at school. And in fact, her parents, her French parents, are here tonight. Lisa Morning and Christiane, and also Gail
somewhere
over here. And after that, she then completed a double degree, during which she had a year's exchange at Madrid University, and then she had to finish with an honors program. But Julia always knew in her heart that she wanted to be a doctor. And that's what she set out to be. And 4 years later, we have Doctor. Yes, I just wanted to sort of talk a little bit about why I thought that Julia being a doctor was actually probably the correct decision in her life. I'll just give you a little story. That last Christmas, she took herself off to Ghana at her own expense. And she did volunteer work in a clinic, a small little hospital just outside Accra. And while she was there, a very young boy was brought in suffering from cerebral malaria. Now, not only was this child completely unable to speak, and was completely paralyzed. Unfortunately, there was nothing they could do at the hospital. They didn't have the training or the facilities or the equipment to do any rehabilitation work there. So Julia then found out that somewhere away there was a clinic that did rehabilitation, actually mainly for amputees, but they did do physical handicap rehabilitation. And it was run by a nun. So Julia then went to see this nun, Sister Elizabeth. And together they sort of said, well, I think we could probably do something for Ashanti. And this is what the little boy's name was. So at their own expense, Julia got Ashanti to this clinic, along with her mother and some of the family. I can't remember, there were quite a few people. And then David and Julia then decided that they were going to pay out of their own sort of pocket for the rehabilitation treatment of Ashanti. Well then, just a little bit later, well, in fact quite a bit later, Julia returned back to Australia, and the most amazing news came through. Julia was keeping in touch with Sister Elizabeth, and Ashanti now could not only speak, he could move all his limbs and was running around like any young boy. And I thought that was, you know, a wonderful outcome. It just sort of describes, I think, Julia's sort of approach to life. Julia, you've not only made, I think, the correct decision in your choice of life partner in David, but you've made the right choice in your the direction of your life. And I would like to just close with a rather appropriate quotation. Sorry, are you hearing me when I go back a bit? Okay. Okay. I'll speak to you later. And this is very appropriate. How far you go in life depends on your being tender with the young, compassionate with the aged, sympathetic with the striving, tolerant of the weak and the strong, because someday in your life you will be all of these. And now I'm going to ask you all to rise and toast the bright and good. Julia and Dave.
Julia and Dave.
All right, thanks very much, Howard. That was great. The next one we're going to have. So, next we're going to have Sarah, Jules' sister, and the maid of honor.
Hi everyone.
everyone. Hi everyone, I'm Julia's baby sister, for those I haven't had the chance to meet yet. So I'm a bit of a nervous public speaker, so excuse my shaky voice. Firstly, I would like to thank Julia's best friends and beautiful bridesmaids, Susie, Kiara and Nikki, for all their help today and in the lead up to today. Julia's very lucky to have three such long-standing, loving and unique friendships as she does with all of you. So thank you so much for your help. I would also like to thank the groomsmen, Dean, Simon, Zane and Houston, for getting Dave to the altar on time. For getting Dave to the altar on time, no mean feat, given both Jules and Dave's reputation for tardiness, so well done. And finally, I want to thank our parents and Marion Roberts for all their work and tireless efforts leading up today. The amount of moving parts that needed to be coordinated for this weekend to happen was mind-blowing. I know Jules and Dave really appreciate everything you've done. Growing up with Julie Inman, where to start? Even before I was born, Julie made it very clear who was going to be the boss when this new sibling arrived by apparently throwing my cot downstairs. This trend continued into our childhood, this time with me being semi-regularly thrown downstairs. Despite being used as an occasional human punching bag, growing up with Julia was great. I remember playing together for hours and hours, completely consumed in our own imaginary world, whether it was playing dress-ups, putting on a show, or turning our Wendy house into a restaurant, where the only thing on the menu was water and stale biscuits. Needless to say, we went bankrupt. Almost every wonderful childhood memory I have features Jules. Julia did not take the role of being a big sister lightly either. One memory that stands out was on a school holiday language camp we were sent to improve our terrible Afrikaans. So there we were, out on this dairy farm in the middle of South Africa, knowing about three words of Afrikaans between the two of us. I remember one afternoon I was playing with two other girls, the Pendle sisters, when things rapidly turned south for me after a dispute broke out. I can't even remember what it was about, but I'm sure it was something very important to my eight-year-old self. As I took the fetal position, ready to take the beating that was inevitably coming my way, I heard this little voice from behind shout out, "Back away, busted." There she was, Julia, this feisty little blonde, 10-year-old, short for her age, pissed up and ready to rumble. I wish I could say we won that fight, but I'm pretty sure we got walloped. That aside, the point is that Julia had my back, as she did countless more times as we grew up. I remember when Jules told me that her and Dave had decided to get married. Though I was so excited for the two of you, I remember feeling this sense of sadness. Up until now, I had always been Julia's go-to person. The shoulder to cry on, the person to vent to or laugh with when something hilarious just happened. I realised that Dave was now this person for Jules. And so I officially hand over the baton, knowing that he will be able to do a much better job than I ever could. Dave, you have brought such a light into my sister's life. I see her when she's with you and she glows with the love and mutual respect that you both so obviously share. I know that you will be the safe harbour in the storm for my beautiful sister, and that she will be the same for you. So I'd like to make a toast to Jules and Dave. I wish you both all the happiness in the world, and may for better or worse be far better than worse. To Jules and Dave.
Thanks very much, Sarah. I have a few letters I'd like to read from friends and family. The first one, I'm just going to read out. I'm going to have to decipher some handwriting and some low light levels, so excuse me if it doesn't come off perfectly. This brings our congratulations and best wishes to you both on this happy day. May you choose love, compassion, and understanding as you journey together in building an enduring marriage. We wish you every blessing today and always. Love and joy, Hal and Harvest Smith. Our love and best wishes for a blessed life together from Pete and Nikki Newpin. And lots of love and best wishes from Terry, Helen and Liam. Then from the Torellos I have, dear Julia and David, hola. That's some excitement. Have the most amazing time. Be thinking of you every single minute, wishing we were there with you both. We're sorry we cannot be there with you, with our very special love. I'll try to name Mercedes, Federico, Pablo, Thomas, and Marcos from Spain, Barcelona, Spain. Then I have, dear Julia and Dave, firstly, congratulations to you both. You are now members of the club. Trust me, it's a great membership to have, but don't forget to pay your dues to each other, often, or the membership could lapse. James, Katia, Lucy, and Alitha and I would like to wish you both a very happy, healthy, contented, and fruitful life together. Sadly, we're not able to be with you to celebrate this exciting occasion, but can assure you of our warmest wishes and thoughts today as you start your new life together. We'll be raising a glass or three to you both. Julia, I'm sure your godfather, Chick, would have had some wonderful words of wisdom for you if he were still here. In fact, I think he's probably closer to you in the bush right now than we are. He would have been proud to know that you had sailed through your finals and are now a fully fledged doctor. Dave, we are sorry not to have met you yet, but we'd certainly like to remedy that in the not too distant future. Take from me that your wife is a mean cook sister maker. She will tell you the story, holiday in Portugal comes to mind. If I may close with some words of advice to keep your marriage safe. When you are wrong, admit it. When you are right, shut up. That's it. And with those words, we wish you a wonderful celebration together with your families and friends and look forward to seeing you sometime in 2015. And that's fondest love from Joe, James, Katia, Lucy, and Alethea. All right, those are the letters we have. Next, I'd like to turn to the brothers, Dave's younger and older brothers, Zane and Simon. Just raise this a meter. The Webster's definition of marriage is a Jane.
Hi everyone, I'm Zane, Dave's eldest brother. This is Simon, Dave's youngest brother, making David the middle brother, subject sometimes to middle brother syndrome. David's known as Darby, Dolly the Duffer Duck, and Dave. I will refer to David as Dolly from this point onwards.
Danger.
Now, I could tell you, hey?
Dangerous
Dave. I could tell you some stories about David bribing high school security guards, stealing speakers to set up illegal parties at Clifton with his best man and younger brother, but I'll leave that to the best man.
It's not true.
In a quest to try and explain David better to everyone, I did what most people do in 2014 and started with a Google search. I Googled middle brothers and came up with the following. It's not surprising that because of their calm and heightened attention to what's going on around them, they tend to be keepers of peace. A middle child has a true gift in the art of calming people down, being an ear to listen or a shoulder to lean on. This was evident on many occasions when David broke up some severe fights between Simon and I. A couple of months ago, David, my wife and I, Chantel, had the privilege of visiting David and Julia in Perth. This was our first trip to Australia, so it was quite an exciting time. And in the short period of time, getting to know Jules and David and seeing them interact together, we were able to see their mutual love and respect for one another. And also notice how their polar opposite personalities were able to complement one another. Dave, you're a loving, caring, and genuine brother, and I'm proud to be able to call you my brother.
Thanks, bro.
In closing, I've got a couple of words from Dad who wasn't able to make it tonight. So here goes. To this day, and probably forever, I will remember meeting Julia, but not in the way that one might expect. You see, the way I first saw Julia was not in person, but through the impact you had made upon David. I could see you in his walk, in his talk, and in his smile, and most profoundly in your eyes, David. Something profound had happened to you, Darby, and it was good. But of course, it was not something, it was you, Julia. And so, as I say, that is how I first met you. When we met in person a short while later, with the two of you standing together, it was very clear to me from the electric energy I saw between you and the same person whose impact I had seen so clearly in David, was standing beside him and he beside you. As father of the groom and now father-in-law to the bride, may I propose a toast to the two of you. To David and Julia, may you have a wonderful life together. May your joys be uncountable. May your troubles be few. May your laughter from your hearts echo loudly. To David and Jules.
Cheers. All right. I'll start by just giving you a little bit of my view on Dave's character. I think Dave has a ton of character, and I know myself, certainly a better man for having spent many years of school and varsity alongside him at home. And I know many of the Aussies have had that privilege with his time in Perth. I kind of see Dave as a systems integrator. That means you take pieces from everywhere and you put them together to make something better than the whole is better than the sum of the parts. So Dave listens well, and he discerns what he'll take on as his own and what he'll leave as somebody else's. Be it advice, ideas, opinions, or taste, and of course his accent. In the few years that Dave has been in Oz, he certainly picked up some twangy words. You'll hear him saying things like, "Julia! Yeah!" And even at his Bucks party, or bachelor's party for the Saffers, he says, "Oh, I get a beer out the Esky." Dave really is the king of cool. He's calm, and he's cool, he's collected, and he's got enough for us all. So whenever you're too worried about something, give him a shout. He'll help you gain some perspective on things, and his ability to calm on even the worst days. And in fact, I believe even today, his hand was at play in helping Jules remain calm before she walked down the aisle. Now, this isn't a 21st, but as a youngest brother, I ought to stir a little mischief. And Julia, now that this is all legal and signed, thanks to Susie, I think I can share with you a lesser known tale of the much loved Dave. Hold on to your chairs, Peter. In his rebellious youth, he felt the need to join the local gangsters in Cape Town in the pursuit of expression of speech. That is, written speech in the form of graffiti. I'll cut a long story short. Dave ran short of, he ran out of spray paint. He snuck into a local supermarket and did a very poor job of stealing. Some extra spray paint. He had to be bailed out by my mum, who, of course, in her good faith, was convinced that it must have been a mistake. David would never do anything like that. Yes, mum, he stole. Thankfully, that's where the kleptomania ended. Thank you, Gail. Other than, of course, stealing Julia's heart. Julia,
Julia. Did I get it right? Yeah, I'm so happy to be a part of the family with you and to have you as a part of our family. And being the youngest of three boys, you know, you think everything's quite male. Everything leads to the male way of doing things. And now that Dav is the last one getting married, it's awesome to have a fully fledged complement of women and men balancing out the Roberts boys. I look forward to many a good debate with you on family holidays. We've all heard about how strong Jules' opinions are. Yeah, and then to Dave and Jules, we wish you guys all the happiness in the world. And of course, not accusational conversation. If you guys can stand and raise a glass. And drink a toast to David and Julia.
Thanks, guys. So, I think we all agree that it's been an absolutely incredible wedding so far. From the game drives to last night's feast, thank you very much to those who organized. To the breathtaking accommodation with its myriad of spiders, crickets, moths, praying mantises and more. I'm not sure about you folks, but my night started with an interesting night, actually. I had a game ranger knock on my door furiously at about 11:30 saying, "Hi, you know, could you just please keep the door locked until the morning, because we've got a situation." Of course, any human's going to say, "Might you embellish on that situation so I can be subtly prepared for what happens?" Anyway, so the gentleman suggests to me that there may be six bull elephants circumnavigating my beehive. So anyhow, I say thank you, great to know. And of course he says, "Have a good night." And, that I did, you know. Anyway, so didn't get much sleep on the first night. Anyway. So, yeah, nevertheless, I can say with absolute sincerity, it's been a wonderful experience thus far, and I absolutely promise to make this the quickest 45-minute speech that you've ever had, so thank you. So where do we start? First of all, I want to say thank you very much to the two of you for affording me the opportunity to speak, and to be MC, and to hand out the rings, and for everything else in between. It's been an absolute honor. It really has been. I believe that it all started in the turn of the millennium, at the turn of the millennium, the year 2000, when I remember a kind of shy, lanky, pale, slightly sleepy-looking dude walk into my house. This person, Dave, was accompanied by his older brother, Zane. I don't even know if you remember this. Zane was my brother's friend, Andrew. Sorry, I'm not going to go down the rabbit hole. But Zane walks in and says, "Hey, Andrew. Don't worry, Dave's here. He can play with Dean." Nice one. So, I seem to recall being a little disgruntled at the time because I was kind of knee-deep in some coding. I was programming something to manipulate the time domain of an audio signal or something. Nevertheless, I remember I lifted my head and made eye contact with Dave. And it was a feeling that I can only liken to the feeling of when a stray kitten from the SPCA gives you their sales pitch. Those kind of plaintive eyes that gaze upon you. Anyway, so naively I thought to myself, why not just deal with it for this one afternoon, you know? Come on, how hard could it be? Well, let me tell you, by the end of the afternoon, it was me that was convincing Dave to stay. At the time, I couldn't quite understand why, but there was certainly something about Dave that I found Moorish, rather addictive. You know, if I think, I mean, just to summarize, and it's really hard to summarize a relationship like Dave and mine, Dave's and mine, forget it. It's really hard because we've gone to Thailand together, we've run businesses together, you know, we've gone clubbing together, we've stolen together, we've even burnt each other. You know, there's so much history there. So anyway, the reason I'm telling this is 14 years later, I look at him and I see that so much has changed, but so much has stayed the same. Although Dave's still in the top 10 most chilled category, you know, with his new favorite Aussie phrase, what is it? I can't even remember. Oh, it means chill out. It means no dramas. I mean, in my life, I've never heard anyone say that, but they have everything up. Ah, no dramas. So, it is what it is. Anyway, no dramas. But he's out there making it happen. He really is. He's building a gargantuan hotel in Oz, making waves in the property industry. And although I used to catch him sleeping in the upright position, he now is the guy that's actually making practice calls to me and checking off if I'm okay. You know, do you need a loan? I mean, I divide by 10. Don't forget that. So very kind of you. Thank you. Pride remains. And in fact, I think it was only yesterday that I finally came to understand what really was about Dave that's so different from others. We were sitting down conducting what some would refer to as a creative workshop around the timing of today's proceedings. And as things go, the situation may have become a little heated. But as I looked around the table, desperately trying to hold onto the underlying thread of this interwoven conversation, my eyes caught Dave smiling to himself, blissfully and beautifully disengaged from the entire situation, which, may I remind you, was the organization of his wedding. And then out of the blue, he says, with the sort of golden blue aura surrounding his head, Dave's aura, you know, love that thing, he just says, why don't we all just take a break, you know? And of course, we hadn't really got anywhere or achieved anything, but that wasn't the point. Things just simply weren't chilled enough for us. So what is it again? No, there were too many dramas. So, Dave, there's a constant ability that Dave has to diffuse any tense situation by tranquilizing his opponent, with one single calm sentence, and that's what makes Dave Dave. I believe him to be the one and only human sedative. Dave, in all seriousness, you never push the river, you never go on the offense, you never argue with an incorrect opinion. You listen twice as much as you speak and offer infinitely more than you would ever expect from others. And I think that's why I've been so inspired by you over the past years. Simply because you're rare. And I'm pretty sure that's why you're sitting next to the most beautiful, bubbly, motivated, intelligent, and caring person next to you today. Jules?
Yeah.
To Jules. And Mel. Jules, although I've only known you for a few years, in fact, I remember when you guys met. It was on the SIP couch at Stardust in Rondebosch. Anyway, that's for a 30th or something. I don't know. That was a beautiful place, by the way. Very romantic, upstanding. Although I've only known you for a few years, I honestly can't think of a time that we've spent together and not laughed, including yesterday's creative workshop. You have an amazing energy about you and an incredible zest for life. And like Dave, you get people, which makes you such a pleasure to be around. You look, as I said earlier, incredibly beautiful tonight, and I really couldn't have wished for a better life companion for my best man, Dave. I would also like to thank you for introducing me to all your wonderful friends and bridesmaids. So many friends and so many bridesmaids. And let me take this opportunity to toast the bridesmaids on just how stunning they'd look tonight. We have to say, do we not? No, seriously, all of your wonderful friends are a clear reflection of you both, and I'm honoured to be one of them, because I am one of them. Don't forget. So, I'm not a big quotes guy. I read a few, but none of them really kind of were you, so I lost them. So I'd like to ask everyone to raise their glasses to toast the bride and groom and join me in saluting them on their most marvelous journey of life ahead. Continue to be true to us and to one another because you're both damn amazing. Thanks, guys. All right, so it's not over just yet. Of course, there's one dude who has to make a speech. Dog. Would you like to make a speech, Doc?
Yeah.
You may have pressed the button. Yet. Please hold. 10-4, 10-4. It's the music.
It's
1-2-4. Hello. All right. Julia, my wife. I haven't seen your dress. It's been hanging on the back of our door for months, but I never peeked. And I'm sure a few of you noticed me welling up just this earlier this afternoon when Jules was walking down the aisle. And it was pretty hard not to, because you look fantastic.
Yes, you do.
To everyone here, congratulations, you found the place. A big thank you to everyone for all the effort that you've gone to in getting here and making today possible. When Julia and I first sent out invitations, we never anticipated such a phenomenal turnout. It's a strange concept, having a black tie in the bush, but ladies, you all look fantastic, and guys, you scrub up not too bad. So thank you to all the travellers, and I guess that's everyone. But some of us are further than others. To Rod and Sheila, all the way from San Francisco, for Kiara, popping in from New York, and the rest of the Lowry family, Gary, Viv, Ben, Elliot from Oz, from the UK, Dan and Celia, and Paul and Adrian, Christiane, Monique, and Gachel, and Gail Tachon from Lyon. Merci beaucoup pour avoir venu. To all the Australians who've made it out here, I know that you've all been having a great time, and I'm sure you're all wondering why you haven't done this earlier. And not forgetting the Kiwis either. The Fanikos, the Goodings, the Leavesleys, and Fran from Johannesburg, thanks for making the effort. And to all the Capetonians, well, I know anything over 30 minutes travel is practically a transatlantic flight. Howard, where are you? Thanks for shaking my hand. Seriously, thank you for your kind words, and a huge thank you to you and Lorna for putting on such an amazing event. When Julie and I first dreamt of this as a wedding location, neither of us could have imagined it would have been this spectacular. But I'm sure everyone will agree with me that this has been an incredible weekend thus far. I know that Howard and Seamus will agree with me that the amount of time and effort Lorna and Sarah have put into making this weekend possible is off the charts. Not to mention the patience required in dealing with Julia and myself. Massive thank you to you all. Howie, Lorna, Sarah, and not forgetting Maverick and Penny, thank you for welcoming me into your lives and into the family. You provided me so much support, and you've made me feel part of the family. You're an amazing family, and I look forward to many more celebrations and adventures together. Sarah, my sis. Thank you so much for taking good care of Jules and for always backing her. Seamus, you're on a winning ticket. Thank you to my parents for everything you've done for me and my brothers, the way in which you have so generously provided for us all. To both the mums, you're an inspiration to us both, and you both look incredible tonight. Lorna, you're an incredible person, and I'm pleased to call you my mother-in-law. Mum. Woo! Mum, thank you so much for all your love and support. It means so much to have you here. To the bridesmaids, I know that Sarah has already thanked you. However, I wanted to thank you all for your friendship that you have with Jules, and a brief reminder that you're all very lucky to have Jules as a friend. I trust that we'll be seeing lots more of you and many for many years to come. To the groomsmen, well, Dean, or Simo,
We've been best friends since the first year of high school, and we've done pretty much everything together, as Dean mentioned at least. But I will recount one story which he did mention, and it involves a homemade jet turbine engine and what you could call a malfunction. A series of flames and an unprepared David standing there like a stunned mullet, attempting to put out the fire on the turbine while Dean's leg is being engulfed in flames. Dean, I contrast that story to what I have, to what I now know, and that is, I'll always have your back. You're a great friend, and I'll always treasure the time we spend together. To Zane and Simon, my two brothers, which make up us three boys, you have both led the way in terms of getting married, and Chantel and Emma, you make fantastic partners for my brothers. I will have to continue to get great advice from you both. Thank you for everything you do for the family. To Andrew, or Huso, thank you for your speech yesterday. Moving countries is not easy, and as some of you know, it's a much easier feat if you find people who make it a lot easier. Andrew, thanks for being a great friend and a great housemate. You've made it a lot easier. Cheers, mate. And thank you to the rest of the people who have also contributed massively to organising this. Mum, for all your help and being the key person here in South Africa, thank you very much. For Maurice, ensuring that I am precisely at 9:20 doing my speech, and for ensuring that everything is running roughly on time. To Neil and the staff at Gondwana, thank you all for your friendly assistance. For those of you that don't know, well, in fact, Dean just told you all, but Jules and I met in a small karaoke bar in Cape Town, Stardust. And we then proceeded to an even better establishment, Tiger Tiger. It didn't take long for me to realise that it was quite simply, that you were quite simply the most exciting and energetic person I'd met. A few dates followed, and I showed up well-dressed. Which later I found out was a key move. Holidays in Australia, sailing in Greece, a getaway in Franschhoek, and the deal was sealed. I was on my way to Australia. And now, 3.5 years later, we're both here. Julia, the vows you made to each other this afternoon, the most significant words I've ever said, not to mention non-confrontational. You mean everything to me. You're my rock, my darling, my number one, my love. As you'll all witness later, when Jules and I have hit the dance floor, we are and will continue to be a kick-ass couple.
Thank you. I fall off my chair, and I'm wondering how I get down the stairs. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right, here I am, stuck in the middle with you. Yes, I'm stuck in the middle with you, and I'm wondering what it is I should do. It's so hard to keep the smile from my face, losing control, yeah, I'm all over the place. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right, here I am, stuck in the middle with you. When you started out with nothing and you're proud that you're a selfish man, and your fans, they all come calling, slap you on the back and say, please, please. Try to make some sense of it all, but I can see it makes no sense at all. Is it cool to go to sleep on?
Are you too bad for man?
monyet Goose le bole borolo and meet moget. Forget about the flag you get go wack. So holo holo your bags on track you check. Back by mass demand is this anthem. And we pack the same command from where it came from. Jack to jack plug in more systeming. Got my white and black my EP all streaming.